researcher. I'm specialized in youth politics and youth policies and social policies in Europe, and I'm associated to the Centre d'études européennes at Sciences Po. And I'm here to do an interview co-hosted by TEPSA with the member of the European Parliament, Miss Leïla Chaibi. Good evening, Leïla Chaibi.
Good evening, Tom.
So, as an introduction, can you please introduce yourself and describe us your political trajectory?
Yes, my name is Leïla Chaibi. I've been elected in the European Parliament in 2019. Before I was elected in the European Parliament, I used to be involved in a social movement against the housing crisis in an association called Jeudi Noir. We denounced and we made action against the fact that even when you have a job, it's become impossible to find a decent house in big city like in Paris. And I've been also involved against for the youth employment and against the abuse of internship, and also and in the European Parliament, I am member of several committees, the employment and social affair committees, and also in the constitutional affair. And I'm also member of the transport and tourism committee.
Thank you very much. And so what are your policy objectives in the Parliament?
Well, of course, because of my because of what I used to do before I was elected, my main issue are the social issue. And my main dossier is the matter of giving rights to platform workers. But more globally, I think one of my objectives when I've been elected is to democratize the European Union, because now the European Union and the European Parliament seems very, very far from the citizens. And I think it's important that we show all what we do in the European Parliament to bring outside of the European Parliament all what's happening, because these are the decisions that are taken inside the European Union, inside the European Parliament. It has an effect on everybody's life, of the citizen life, on the member state politics, and it's very important for us to communicate it outside. And also, on the other hand, for me, it's very important to bring the voice of the main concern inside the European Parliament. And for example, in the issue of platform workers, for me, it's very important to explain outside things that can look, that can seem a bit abstract, difficult, the way we are building a directive to protect platform workers, to explain outside what's my job inside the European Parliament. But at the same time, it's very important for me to bring the voice of the riders, of the drivers, people working for Deliveroo, Uber, or that platform, to bring that voice inside the European Parliament to build a kind of bridge for their voice, because I think inside the European Parliament, we listen a lot to the lobby, to the but not so much to the citizen. So for me, I could summarize it in a one foot inside and one foot outside of the institution.
Thank you. This is very interesting, because you already talk about the policy making and how the European Union can implement and adopt some kind of policies. So can you tell us a little bit more about how does it work concretely for a member of parliament? About with regard to the policy making, how do you go from having an idea and going to making a proposal and going into legislation?
I am a member of the European Parliament, and inside the European Parliament, you have several groups. I am a member of the French, we have 79 MEPs who come from France, who are elected by French citizens. These 79, they are in several groups. I am part of a group which is called the Left. It's the smallest group. We are 42 MEP in that group. Six of us are from France. And so when we take a decision, we try to do it with the group collectively. And you're talking about how the decisions are made. Well, the European Parliament doesn't have the right of initiative. It means that we are not able, as, for example, the Assemblée Nationale in France, the French Parliament, we don't have the right to initiate law. We don't have the right to write the first draft. But we have to wait for the European Commission who give a proposal, a legislative proposal, and then we have what we called an initiative legislative report, which means that the European Commission make a proposal, and the Council, the representative of the government and the European Parliament, the MEPs, they have to amend the proposal from the Commission. We also have another kind of report, which it's called the initiative report, and it gives the position of the Parliament about an issue. So a big part of the decision making, first of all, is to make a pressure on the European Commission in order that the European Commission send a proposal to the European Parliament. And that kind of job, I did it about platform workers, which means that, if I can take this example, Ursula von der Leyen in 2019 said, we have to work on platform workers, it's a big issue. Anyway, in the world, they are working, but without status, without security, and so we need to resolve solve this problem. Then we had to wait for the proposal from the Commission. So, in order to have the quickest proposal from the Commission, we can use several ways. For example, the way I used was to write a draft of directive, even if I didn't have the right, but just to say, okay, to see the commissioner, the employment commissioner, and say, okay, we are in a hurry because with the COVID, we all saw that while we were in lockdown, these workers, they were in the street working without security, without social security, and so you have to work on that. Maybe you can copy-paste my proposal. It was to come to the debate. And but then with the Parliament, in the parliamentary work, in the employment committee, we started working on an initiative report, which was the position of the European Parliament about platform worker. And for this initiative report, you have one rapporteur, but you have also shadow rapporteur who represent their group in the negotiation. I represented my group in the negotiation. I was shadow rapporteur from the group the left. And so we work all together. We have a first draft from the rapporteur, and then we send amendment, and then we try to find compromise amendment, because in the European Parliament, the Parliament work a lot from compromise amendment. And then at the end, you have a report voted in the plenary session, which is the position of the European Parliament. And the European Commission is supposed to follow the recommendation of the European Parliament. Then the Commission sends the proposal. Will send her proposal in December. We will write on a legislative report, which means the work since the draft, the first draft of the legislative proposal, and then we have to find a solution between the representant from the state and government, the European Commission, and the European Parliament.
This is very interesting, but very complicated as well.
Yeah, too much complicated, I think.
Policy making at the EU level is very complicated, but it's also very, sometimes it seems very far from citizens, and many people can criticize the EU level because it seems like so limited and also complicated. And so do you understand this criticism, and what kind of obstacles are there that we can cope with to be more to improve the policy making at the EU level?
I totally understand the citizen when they said that European Union seems very far, European decision making is very far, is very understandable. I totally understand, and I think it's a pity. First of all, it's a pity that the European Parliament is the only institution in the European Union that is elected by citizens. And if we want that the citizens care about the European Union, we have to give more power to the European Parliament, because you elected people, you elect people, but that people, you have to explain to the citizens that they will not be able to write the first draft of the directive, they will not be able to propose, to make a proposal of law or of directive. So I think we have to democratize the European Union if we want that the citizens, they find it useful. This is very important, because for the citizen it seems far, it seems very far physically, because as you know, the European Parliament is in Strasbourg, but most of the job is in Brussels. So you see, something else complicated. It's in Strasbourg, it's in Brussels, what? Right. And the European Commission in Brussels, but it's also far in the way the decision is made. And to explain that once you have a directive, you need 3 years, the member states need 3 years to implement it. So I think we have to democratize the European Union, but I think also the politics that are made have to be more social, and that will be a way also to close, to make people closer from the European Union.
Well, thank you very much, Miss Leïla Chaibi, and have a nice evening, and thank you for listening, and goodbye.